My dear students of second year, I am Raghvendra Pratap, and again I am here with some of the rest content of the first unit, Fundamentals of Communication. As I said this earlier in my previous video, that some of my students requested me to use both the languages, so I will try at its max to use both the languages, but still, if something remains untouched in both the languages, yadi fir bhi kuch chhoot jata hai, still something which I could not like make that explained in both of the languages, Hindi and English, please leave your comments so that I can answer that better. Okay, so with the better health of everyone, let's move ahead to know the rest part of this unit. So the first thing which we will understand here, that is characteristics of language. Yahan par dhyan se dekhiyega, I am moving my cursor, you need to just focus your sight here. We are going to know some of the characteristics of language. Hum bhasha ke charitrik visheshtaon ko janne wale hain, means something which characterize a thing. So the characteristics of a language is all about something which made it a language, jin cheezon ne isko bhasha banaya. So let's understand this all. So here are some of the characteristics, one by one we'll go through these all. The first thing, language is a social phenomenon. This is the first characteristic of language, that it is a social happening, means without efforts it will come in picture. Is that clear what I said? Social phenomenon means it is a natural event, it is a natural happening. The same I wrote it here for the understanding of every one of you. This isn't a natural act, this is a social act, this is a social event, this is a social happening which will come in picture automatically. This is the first characteristics. We all do know speaking is a social act, and that can be done with the language. We all do know, is that clear? If we want to like say something, if we want to listen something, ultimately speaking part is there, yes or no, to say something, to transfer something, to communicate something. So ultimately a thing which will come in picture will be called a language. So language is a social phenomenon is the first characteristic. Is that clear? Language is a social phenomenon. Let's move ahead to the second one. As a second characteristic, language is arbitrary. I've tried to understand this word arbitrary. I know some of you must be. Mujhe nischit hai some kuch log aise honge jo is word ko pehli baar sun rahe honge, but it is very much essential to use this word as a here as a characteristic. Ye bahut zyada zaruri hai ki shabd ko yahan par aisa ka aisa use kiya jaye. So language is arbitrary, it means as you wish so as you use. Jaisa aap chahte hain waisa aap use karte hain. For your understanding, the same is written here in the parenthesis, as you wish, as per your own wish, manmani. Okay, jaisa aap chahte hain waisa hi bhasha ka use karte hain. It is not like a forced impose, it is not a force. Yes, there are some force to use a language. Hum ye jante hain bhasha ko use karne ke kai rules hote hain, but that doesn't mean ke har koi ek sa hi bole. Even after following all the rules of a language, no one can be similar in the use of a language. In the use of a language, no one can be similar. So the same thing is written, language is arbitrary, means as you wish so as you use it. Jaisa aap chahte hain waisa hi aap iska use karte hain. The third characteristic of language is a means of communication. As we understood in our previous video, language is a tool of communication. As a characteristic, language always comes in picture to becomes a medium. Again, I'm saying language always comes in picture to becomes a medium to share the information. That's why this too is a characteristic. Ye hamesha ek madhyam banti hai. Language is a means of communication. It becomes a medium. Is that clear? So this too is a characteristic. Language comes in picture to interact. It's a way to communicate. So this is the third characteristics of a language. Let's move ahead to the fourth characteristic. Language is systematic. Now, as I said to explain, language is arbitrary. Jaisa ki maine language is arbitrary ko explain karte samay bola tha, yes, there are some of the rules which are strictly followed by all the user of a language. Kisi bhi bhasha ko, chahe wo Japanese ho, English ho, German ho, any language, there are some rules. Exactly, after like knowing these rules, it is called a system. Like when you talk about some of the rules of a language, this gives that language a system. Means all the languages are systematic. Means you cannot ignore the use of the grammar of those all languages. Grammar means those specific rules which must be strictly followed by. Is that clear? So language is systematic. Ye grammatical structure ko follow karti hai. So this too is a characteristic of a language. Let's move on to the fifth one. Language is vocal. We all do know. Yadi hum jab bhasha ki baat karte hain, so bhasha is a combination. Means language is a combination of two different things. First one is the words which we say, and second one is the words again which we write. So bolne wali bhasha and likhne wali bhasha, means language to speak and script to use it. Ye ek hi bhasha ke do alag alag ayam hote hain. So please try to understand, language is vocal. When you talk about the language as a characteristic, first comes in picture, it is vocal. Ye articulatory hai, means it is spoken by the articulators, which applies to all the languages. Hum achhi tarah jante hain, chahe duniya mein koi bhi bhasha ho, whatever language there is in this world, all languages are used by the articulators. Articulators means ye jo shabd likha hua hai, articulators means all those parts, all those organs which helps you out to pronounce the sounds of a language. Wo sabhi hisse aapke sharir ke, means aapke muh ke andar ke, aapke gale ke, jo aapko kisi bhi awaz ko, kisi ek khas bhasha ki awaz ko pronounce karne mein madad karte hain. So language is vocal. Two is a characteristic. Let's move on to the sixth and seventh, which are probably the last characteristics of a language. Language is abstract. Can anyone of you let me know how many of you can see a language, or how many of you ever see a language? Kya aap kabhi bhasha ko dekh sakte hain? Yes, some of you must be saying, yes, when it is written we can see. No, you see the script. Aap ek likhe hue lipi ko dekhte hain. Script means lipi. Aap lipi ko dekhte hain. You cannot see how a language looks like. Abstract is all about something you cannot touch. A language, bhasha, shapeless hai. It is not with any shape. Words are essential for the same is written, the words are essential for the vocal language. Shabdon ki zarurat hoti hai vocal language ke, language ke liye, which expresses its meaning and create understanding, but in abstract form. In simple way main ise samjhane ki koshish karta hun. Language are the best medium to say anything to others, to transfer any idea to others, to express your thoughts to others. But even when it is the only medium to transfer something, one of the most important medium to transfer your thoughts to others, then too it doesn't have a shape. Iska koi shape nahi hai. Language is abstract. So this too is a characteristic. You cannot touch it. You use it, but you cannot touch it. You cannot say how big, how beautiful, how smart the Hindi language, how systematic, how smart and how beautiful English language or German language or Arabic language. You cannot say. So language is abstract. And the last one is language is creative. And this is the last characteristic of a language. Language is creative. If I'm not wrong, we understood that language has a system. Means it is very much important. I'm explaining the last point. Language is creative. It is very much important to follow some of the rules of a language. Ye bahut zyada zaruri hai ki kuch bhasha ke, ye bahut zyada zaruri hai ki bhasha ke kuch khas niyamon ka palan kiya jaye. But then too, lekin fir bhi ye wo creativity hai. This is that creativity which can be done by some of the people to make it, to use it differently. The same as looking written, language is a common but yet new words and different styles like poetry, prose can be the style of anyone's creativity. Hum achhi tarah jante hain bhasha ka prayog, main bhi bahut acha janta hu bhasha ka prayog, aap log bhi acha jante hain. If I'm not wrong, me too is very much perfect to use Hindi and English language perfectly, as well as lot many of you are very much perfect in Hindi and English language, means with the usage of both these two languages. But like are we really too much perfect to make the poetries as the some other people do it? Are we really very much good into write something related to prose in any of the languages? Some of you could be, but not everyone. This is called the creativity, which gives the different insight, to others. हर कोई व्यक्ति अपनी अपनी comfortability zone के हिसाब से भाषा का प्रयोग करता है, भाषा को creativity के तौर पर यूज करता है. So these seven words, some of the characteristics of a language. Let's move ahead some of the other things of the same unit. So here where I'm moving my cursor, this is all about some of the dimensions of communication. And if I'm not wrong, all of you do know dimension is all about the different sides of something. क्या मैं गलत हूं कि आप सभी अच्छी तरह जानते हैं डायमेंशन का मतलब, यानी कि किसी भी चीज के अलग अलग sides, the different sides of a thing. So we are going to know some of the dimensions of communication. Let's understand this. Dimension of communication has its different sides. Means अलग अलग सतह, अलग अलग आयाम, which makes it different from one another. Basically, there are two different dimensions or two different sides of a communication. यहाँ पर लिखा भी हुआ है, it has two different sides or two different dimensions, which are as verbal communication and non-verbal communication. Do not get confused with only verbal communication. Actually, verbal communication is all about something where you use words either in written or oral form. Again, I'm saying it means verbal communication is characterized further in two different ways. Oral communication and written communication. यहाँ पर हम जानने वाले हैं dimensions of communication के जो दो हिस्सों में divide किया गया है, verbal communication and non-verbal communication. Verbal communication वो communication जहाँ पर आप इसको लिखने में और बोलने में दोनों ही तरीके से यूज करते हैं. That's why verbal communication is further divided into two different categories, which I said earlier as well. And non-verbal communication where the words are not used to say anything. जहाँ पर शब्द बोले ही नहीं जाते, शब्द important नहीं है किसी भी चीज़ को कहने के लिए. Again, I'm saying non-verbal communication is all about something where the words are not used either to say or to write. नहीं बोलने में, नहीं लिखने में. मेरी बात clear है सभी को? Extremely sorry बच्चों. Okay. So non-verbal communication is all about something where you don't use words in either of its form, in written or in oral. So ye kis category mein mana jata hai? If I'm not wrong, all of you must have listened this term, body language or kinesics. Body language means language of body, means the language, the way, the symbols, the gesture, the expressions, the emotion you use related to your body, expressed on your body, expressed by some of your parts of your body, is called body language, where words are not important. Is that clear? Isko technical terminology mein, again I'm saying body language is said in technical terminologies as kinesics. So what all comes under this? Eye expression is a part of body language, facial expression is a part of body language, gesture is the part of body language, body shape and posture is the part of body language, appearance is the part of body language, space language and or proximics is the part of body language. Means every these all things and some of the more things which becomes the part of the body language where words are not important to use either in written or oral form. Let's understand these all one by one. Okay, so if I'm not wrong, kinesics or body language is all about something which expresses about you, who you are and what feeling you have internally. Means what you are thinking inside is reflected outside. That is the complete form of, that is the complete explanation of body language. Okay, the things which comes under it as eye expression. If I'm not wrong, look at the picture which I showed here, this one. The expression which you express, again I'm saying the expression which you express with the help of eyes, jo aankhon ki madad se aap express karne ki koshish karte hain, that is eye expression. Facial expression which comes with the complete effort of all your muscles there on your face, jo aapke chehre par sabhi muscles hain, un sabhi muscles ke use se jo aap express karte hain happiness, sorrow, deep despondency, that is reflect with the help of my facial expression, means with the use of all the muscles, not only with the eyes only. Next one is gesture. Gesture ka ek Hindi shabd zarur provide karunga so that you can get to know, means most of you get can understand it a bit easily. Gesture is all about something, wo ishare jo aap haathon ki madad se karte hain ya fir sar ki madad se karte hain. Sar ki madad se ishare ka matlab, when you nod, means jab aap apne sar ko hilate hain kisi cheez ka samarthan karne mein ya kisi cheez ko oppose karne mein, when you are agree with something or when you are in oppose of something, you nod your head. The two is a gesture. So gesture are those all expressions, those all things which you express to let other people know with the movement of your hands or head. Haathon ke movement se, fingers ke movement se aur head ke movement se jo batane ki koshish karte hain. Body shape and a posture. Posture is all about the way you walk, the way you sit, the way you stand. Is all about the posture. Means which shows your way to stand, to sit or to walk. That is body shape and a posture. You can easily understand with the help of these all pictures how this person is feeling. How this person is feeling while standing. Yes or no? This is this picture shows the posture of a person who is standing. You can like have lot many different postures with the help of you can get to know about a person when he or she is sitting, walking or whatever. Okay. Next one is appearance. Appearance means the way you want to look to others. Bahut simple bhasha mein kehne ki koshish kar raha hu, the way you want to look to others. Aap apne aap ko dusre ko kaise dikhana chahte hain? How you want to show yourself to others? Aap apne aap ko dusre ko kaise dikhana chahte hain? That is all about the appearance. Aap samne wale ko kaise dikh rahe hain? And space language is all about something, the distance. Again, I am saying, chance se sunega. Space language, the distance which you maintain. वो डिस्टेंस जो आप मेंटेन करते हैं व्हाइल कम्युनिकेटिंग विद द डिफरेंट पीपल, मींस दोज हु आर वेरी मच क्लोज टू यू, यू मेंटेन वेरी मच लेस डिस्टेंस. व्हेन यू आर नॉट वेरी मच क्लोज, यू जस्ट नो द पीपल, यू मेंटेन अ बिग डिफरेंस, मींस अ बिग डिस्टेंस टू कम्युनिकेट समथिंग. व्हेन समवन इज वेरी मच अननोन, वेरी मच अननोन, यू मेंटेन अ रियली वेरी मच अ बिग बिट big difference, a bit big difference, thoda sorry, a bit big distance, not difference, distance. Jahan par aap kisi ke prati unknown hote, aapka distance aur zyada badh jata comparatively. And when you address too many of the people, jab aap kisi ko bahut zyada logon ko address karne ki koshish karte hain, when you address public, in that case you maintain the biggest distance with them to communicate something. So this is all about the language which we call, which we name as space language or proxemics. Is that clear? So these are some of the different dimensions expressed in a non-verbal form of communication. Let's move ahead to understand some of the basic differences between oral communication and written communication. हम यहाँ पर जानने वाले हैं कुछ ऐसे differences को जो oral और written communication को oral और written communication के बारे में हैं. Okay? Let's understand the first difference. For the oral communication, communication depends on the spoken word is all about the oral communication. When the communication is depending purely on the spoken words, means bole hue shabdon ke upar, that becomes, that is called oral communication. But when communication is depending on the written words, means on the script, is called written communication. The same as written communication takes place through written words or letter is written way of communication or written communication. Second point is, it is not expensive. When you use oral communication, you are not supposed to spend anything. Nothing is required to spend. किसी भी एक पैसे की, एक्सट्रीमली सॉरी द वर्ड विच आई एम गोइंग टू यूज, नथिंग इज रॉन्ग टू यूज दैट, एक्चुअली एक धेले की जरूरत नहीं है. धेला इज एक्चुअली एन ओल्ड करेंसी जो इंडिया में यूज होती थी. एक धेले की जरूरत नहीं, यू आर नॉट सपोज टू स्पेंड अ सिंगल पेनी ऑन टू डू ओरल कम्युनिकेशन. बट वेन इट कम्स टू रिटन कम्युनिकेशन, इट रिक्वायर्स सम अमाउंट टू यूज. जाहिर सी बात है, इट्स क्वाइट नेचुरल, इट्स क्वाइट नॉर्मल, इट्स क्वाइट सिंपल, इट्स क्वाइट एक्सप्लेनेबल इट्सेल्फ कि यदि आप लिख रहे हैं तो आपको पेन की जरूरत पड़ेगी, पेंसिल की जरूरत पड़ेगी. अब यहाँ पे प्लीज आई डोंट वांट एनीवन ऑफ लाइक सच इंटेलिजेंट बॉय हु इज सेइंग कि सर सड़क पे पड़ा हुआ ईंट का टुकड़ा ले सकते हैं, वी कैन राइट डाउन एनीथिंग ऑन द वॉल. बेटा प्लीज लिसन टू मी एवरीवन, एटलीस्ट यू आर यूजिंग समथिंग. ओके यस और नो? You are requiring something. You need something. But for oral communication, you are not supposed to have anything. Whenever a thought is coming to your mind, you are just supposed to open your mouth to express that out. Yes or no? Let's understand the third point, the third difference. It takes less time to communicate. When you are communicating any thought in oral communication, it requires very much less time. But when it comes to the written communication, it really requires much efforts as well as much time. ये ज़्यादा efforts भी required करता है, समय भी ज़्यादा जाता है. Yes or no? Fourth point is proficiency in speech is essential. Means when you are using oral communication, that doesn't mean whatever is coming to you, you can just say no. You must be well perfect to transfer the understanding which is there in your mind as an idea. जो आपके दिमाग में एक विचार के तौर पर कुछ पड़ा हुआ है, एक सुझाव के तौर पर पड़ा हुआ है आपके दिमाग में, आपको उसको सही सही कहने का तरीका आना चाहिए. Exactly. When it comes to written communication, it doesn't mean whenever something is there in your mind and you want to express that out with the written way of communication, you can just write it down. No. Then too, you need to be very much efficient to write that out in a proper grammatical structure. Is that clear? The same is written. Proficiency in speech is essential and proficiency in writing message is necessary. Message ko kaise likha jata hai appropriately? That is required here in written communication. The fifth point, oral communication cannot be considered as authentic. Oral communication cannot be, just one second. Yes, oral communication cannot be considered as authentic. Yade, if you are saying something and people want to prove it, you said it. Will it be possible for them to prove it? You said it? No, not at all. कोई पॉसिबिलिटी नहीं है. एंड प्लीज डू नॉट लाइक शो योर सेल्फ एज आइंस्टाइन कि आप चीजों को रिकॉर्ड करके कहने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं. इफ आई एम सेइंग एनीथिंग in front of you without having any decisive in your device in your hands or in my hand, will you be able to prove I said that? No, not at all. So the thing is, oral communication cannot be considered as authentic. Means jisko hum prove kar sakein, you cannot prove oral communication very much authentic. But when you are writing anything down, jab aap kisi bhi cheez ko likh rahe hain, you have like you need to be very much careful because all the written communication can be used as authentic and real. You cannot ignore you didn't write it. Aap aise ise ignore hi nahi kar sakte ki aapne likha nahi. Let's move on to the last one is oral communication may be ignored by the receiver. When you are saying something to someone and the time is taken too much by you, aapne zyada samay le liya kisi baat ko kehne ke liye, now please. Please remember, it may possible the receiver can roam with his or her mind. Receiver apne dimag ke through kahin ghoomne lag jaye. Means he is present in front of you physically, but he is not able to focus on the message which you are transferring intentionally. Okay? That is, that can be ignored by the receiver. But in written communication, he cannot overlook anything because he need to focus on the reading as well as interpreting that. Is that clear? It is natural. It is natural. So written communication cannot be ignored, but oral communication can be ignored. So these are some of the basic differences between oral communication and written communication. Let's move ahead to know some of the basic differences between verbal and non-verbal communication as well. Hum yahan par verbal and non-verbal communication ke beech mein bhi difference janne ki koshish karenge. So probably this will be the last slide jahan tak sambhavta ye aakhri slide hogi is video ki. So dusre contents hum अगले वीडियो में जानने की कोशिश करेंगे. सो यहां पर हम जानते हैं द डिफरेंस बिटवीन वर्बल एंड नॉन वर्बल. वर्बल याद रखिएगा, वर्बल मींस वेयर यू आर सेइंग समथिंग आदर इन ओरल और रिटन वे ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन. नॉन वर्बल वेयर वर्ड्स आर नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट, वेयर यू आर नॉट यूजिंग एनी वर्ड टू से और टू राइट, जहां पर शब्दों का यूज ही नहीं कर रहे. दिस थिंग दिस कॉन्सेप्ट मस्ट बी देयर इन योर माइंड टू डिफरेंशिएट Is that clear? This must be there in your mind. Okay, verbal is all about something where you are saying something, where you are using the words, as well as where you are writing the words. And non-verbal, where you are not using neither of a method, oral and written, neither of its method. Okay, chali. The first difference, it is fully structured as well as can be taught. Yadi hum verbal communication ki baat karte hain, if we say anything about verbal communication, it is fully structured, means it follows a way to form a sentence orally as well as it requires a way to write a sentence grammatically. Yes or no? So it is fully structured. And as well as one thing which is very much important, can be taught. You can teach this thing to anyone, how to read, how to say something better or how to write something better. Yes or no? But non-verbal communication is less structured. Iska koi khas structure nahi hota. That doesn't mean it may possible if you are supporting this. If you are supporting, if you want to answer something, if you want to say something like, if you are in favor of something, let's take it in such a way. If you are in favor of something, you not in your hands, simply to make the understanding, you can shake your hands. Yes, absolutely. Yes, you can show your thumb to someone. Means anything, any way you can use. It is not a structure that when giving your consent, when giving your consent, you need to do this much of this kind of a gesture. You need to show this kind of a gesture only. That is non-verbal communication, where it is not structured properly, as well as you cannot teach it anyone. It is natural. You can just copy the things, but you cannot teach this. You need to do these all such things to reply, to show the reactions or feedback to someone. Okay. The second point is, it is spontaneous only in certain reactions. Verbal communication. Jab aap kehte hain ya likhte hain, spontaneous means swabhavik. When you say something, first you think of that. Yes or no? Jab aap kuch kehte hain, pehle aap sochte hain. When you write down something which you have already there in your mind, then you give a proper structure to that. Pehle aap sochte hain, likhna chahte hain, to pehle aap usko proper structure dete hain. This is a spontaneous way. But in verbal communication, you cannot be very much spontaneous for all the reactions. Aap hamesha reactions ke liye spontaneous nahi hote, because you require some thoughts, you require some thoughts, pre-processing. What I'm saying, please listen it, you require some pre-processing. And if something is pre-processed, if something is pre-processed, how it can be spontaneous? Yadi wo pre-processed hai, to wo spontaneous kaise ho sakta hai? So it is spontaneous only in certain reactions. In some of the reactions, it is spontaneous. But non-verbal communication is always spontaneous. Ye swabhavik hai. Aap ise kabhi bhi sochte nahi hai. As soon as you listen something, as soon as you respond as soon as you want to respond to someone, it comes naturally. It can come in either of any of your way which you generally use. Okay, this is spontaneous. Third point is, reliable only when body language is used with it. Shabdon ka ek baat yahan pe main jo bolne wala hu, please dhyan se sunega. Shabd jab hum bolte hain, when we say a word or when we write a word ko chhod ke chalte hain, when we say a word, when you are using proper body language to that, jab aap bhasha ke sath, shabd ke sath properly आप अपनी बॉडी लैंग्वेज का यूज कर रहे हैं, तब वो ज्यादा इंप्रेसिव होती है, ज्यादा रिलायबल लगती है. मींस इन सिंपल वे, व्हेन यू आर एक्सप्लेनिंग समथिंग टू योर फादर और मदर, डोंट यू थिंक द वर्ड्स आर नॉट सफिशिएंट एनफ टू मेक देम अंडरस्टैंड समथिंग व्हाट यू वांट? क्या मैं गलत हूं? यदि आप अपने माताजी पिताजी, ये मदर और फादर के साथ कुछ चीज कन्विंस कराना चाहते हैं उनको, तो आप अपने शब्दों के साथ अपनी पूरी बॉडी लैंग्वेज के एफर्ट्स को यूज करते हैं, सो दैट यू कैन मेक देम रियलाइज व्हाट यू वांट. Yes or no? So this is all about, words are more reliable when you use body language with it. But it is, sorry. It is more reliable than words. Non-verbal communication, mein kisi bhi shabd ki zarurat nahi hai. If you want to use non-verbal communication to pass something, to pass a feedback, to let the person know something, there isn't any need of any word. Wahan shabd ki zarurat nahi hai. But बॉडी लैंग्वेज की जरूरत जरूर पड़ती है शब्दों को वैल्यूएबल बनाने में. यू आर रियली इन नीड ऑफ बॉडी लैंग्वेज टू मेक योर वर्ड्स मोर वैल्यूएबल. बट देयर इजंट एनी नीड ऑफ अ What? Isn't any need of a word to make the non-verbal communication valuable. So fourth point is, it includes the words. The verbal communication, it is a combination of words, either in a oral form or in written form. But it includes the gesture, posture and facial expression. Non-verbal communication is the combination of lot many different things where words are not important, where words are not used. Either of its form. So posture, facial expression, eye movements, eye contact, anything, whatever is used by a person to say something. And the last point which shows the difference between verbal and non-verbal communication, it can be used to speak or write. Ye sirf bolne aur likhne ke liye use kiya ja sakta hai, but it cannot be used to speak or write. Is that clear what I said? It can be used to speak or write, ye bolne aur likhne ke liye use kiya ja sakta, but it cannot be used to speak or write. Means non-verbal communication is far away from saying something orally or writing a word something on a paper. So this is not a way to use non-verbal communication is not a way to say or to write down something. It is far beyond this thing. Okay, so these are some of the basic differences between verbal and non-verbal communication. We will get to know about some of the rest content of this unit in my next video. So to get the prior notification, what I'm saying, please listen it. To get the prior notification, please subscribe the channel so that you will be better to get the notification early. Okay, so thank you very much. Please take care of health as well as take care of your family members. Okay, we are facing a very much bad time. We all are facing very much bad time. So May is almost with its high peak, like because of this COVID-19. Okay, so thank you very much, everyone. Bye bye, take care.